Now in this today's lesson, we are going to see about air cable conductivity, heating effect of electric current and electric power and energy. Okay, first, what is electrical conductivity? If I take a substance, right? Now if I say for that substance, what is electrical conductivity? How much it will conduct current? How effectively it will conduct current? Whether it will conduct current in a very good way or in a very lesser way or it won't conduct. So that property, no. So that is called as electrical conductivity. See the definition. It is a measure of ability of a substance to carry electrical current, electric current. So through that substance, how well the current can flow. So that process, that property is called as electrical conductivity. For example, take wood or take this small scale or on metal rod, right? Which will conduct more current in this metal rod or the scale? Metal rod. So I can say electrical conductivity is for more for that rod, metallic rod, when combined with this scale. So this is called electrical conductivity. Okay. Now, usually we say in the previous classes I have told you what are good conductors and insulators. So good conductors always conduct current. No. So then we say good conductors have high electrical conductivity. Okay. Whereas insulators will have very poor conductivity. Okay. Now we are coming to conductivity of water. Very specially about this water. See, usually people will say with wet hands, when you come out of your restroom or bathroom, or when you use your hands, you wash hands in your water, you should not use current electrical appliances. There is an electric, you will get a shock. But do you know, children, pure water is an insulator. Pure water will not conduct current. But now you can ask me a question, then how can we get shock now when electricity is used? All the water what we use for children, whether it is tap water or river water or lake water, whatever it is, it will contain some impurities. Impurities in the form of some salts. Some salts that got dissolved in it. So when even a small impurity is present in water, it will make a very pure water which is not at all a conductor, will become a conductor. Okay. So that's why our household waters will contain some salts inside it. No. So that salts will make the water to conduct the current. But actually, pure water, clean water, very 100% clean water will not conduct current. Keep this in your mind. Okay. Right. Next one. That's why people say with wet hands we should not use electric appliances. Okay. Now we are moving to conductivity of other liquids. You can test this activity at your home, children. You can easily do it. You would have done it already also in your lower classes. When you take lemon juice, right? You can cut the lemon. Inside that lemon, you can insert one copper rod and zinc rod. Just to a small tube plate which you can get in the shops, right? Spare part shops, you can go and ask. The electrical shops also you can go and get. Copper rod and zinc rod. Right, when you conduct it, when you insert that two plates inside a lemon. Right? So when you connect that with an LED bulb, I'll tell you about what is an LED bulb. Or even a small putty bulb, right? Small decorative lamp. So that can glow. Right? So the current what we get from this lemon may not be very high. Right? But it is sufficient enough to glow a LED, a small LED lamp. Okay? Right. So lemon juice, when we insert copper and zinc in it, it will contain some, the light will glow because this lemon juice will contain one juice called citric acid. Say the word, children. C-I-T-R-I-C, citric acid, A-C-I-D. Underline that word in your book. light will glow on a keypad, cell phone keypads, not the touch screen, I'm saying, the older version, right? So then, and even in bridges, on the sides or on the roads, of light will be fixed, right? So they can be called as LED, light emitting diodes. On the bridges sides also they fix this light, right? So these are all the effects of LED. Main properties of LED. Okay. Right now we are going to the next topic: heating effect of electric current. Now we are not about electric current. What is the heating effect? So when we produce fire in a substance, it has to get heated up, right? Now this heating effect can be created by making a current to flow through a substance. For example, right, have you ever touched your tube light or bulb when it glows for some time? Yes, after some time if you touch it, you can feel that hotness in the bulb or tube light. So here, when the current flows through any appliance or any conductor, right? Conductor means what? Any substance which will conduct the current, right? So along with current production, along with the flow of current, some amount of heat is produced in it. So that process of production of heat is called as heating effect of electric current. A conductor gets heated up when current flows through it. This is called heating effect. Right? Now, on what about the factors this heating effect is dependent on? Now, how much this heating effect will change? It will increase if electric current is more. If more current flows, more heating will happen. If less current flows, less heating effect will be created. Now, for how much time the current flows in it? If the current flows for more time, more heating effect will be produced. If current flows for less time, less heating effect will be produced. Next of the material. Now what is that I told? The first example I don't know. One scale and one metallic rod. Example steel scale today. Which will conduct more current here? Absolutely the steel scale, right? So here, this is glass material and that is steel material. So the nature of the material also will decide how much heating effect can be created. Clear children? So what is heating effect? The process of heating when current flows through a body. Okay, so it depends on three factors, very very important questions. It depends on electric current, it depends on time, and it depends upon the nature of the material. Okay, now where do you use this electric heating effect? Here, in tube lights and bulbs, we have little amount of heating only. But in some electrical appliances, we need more amount of heat. Example, our iron box. Heating is the main work, right? Our heater, geysers in the bathrooms, right? And now your kettles. Kettles mean what? The appliance which we use to take the boiled water. And bread toasters. Toasters we use at home, right? And then we have fuse wires which is we keep at the outside of our house. No, fuse. They all use this heating effect on me. How they use? You will learn in your higher classes. So where they use heating effect? It is used in iron boxes, kettles, toasters, geysers, fuse, etc. Okay, now we are moving to electrical power and energy. So there are two concepts here. Along with it, I am going to add one another concept which is called as work. Right. First, let us see what is power. Okay. Power. Rate of work done is called as power. Work that means what? When we do any work, when we apply some force to a substance, okay, it has to move a distance. Or when you switch on the light is glowing. It is the work done to be done by the tube light, right? So every mean red means divided by tide. Red means divided by tide. Rate of Bogdan means Bogdan is denoted by letter W. Right, capital W. And here P is rate. Whenever you say the word rate means you will have to divide it by tide. So rate of Bogdan is called as power. Is called as power. Right. What is its unit? Its unit is watt. Not the spelling WHAT, its spelling is WATT. What is its symbol? Capital W. Okay. So along with these units, we have some other greater units. They are called as kilowatt and megawatt. Kilowatt is represented by KW and megawatt is represented by MW. Kilowatt is said as 10 power 3 watt. 10 power 3 means what? 1000. 10 power 6 means mega and it is 10 power 6 which is called as megawatt. Okay, now you come to the unit of power. I told unit of power is watt. WAT, right? So now unit of power is 1 watt. Work unit is work unit of work is joule. Okay, so work unit is joule, time unit is second. So 1 watt is equal to 1 joule by 1 second. If the second is in denominator, when it goes up, it will go with power minus 1. So 1 watt is equal to 1 joule per second. So all the three things are already yes. So 1 watt is equal to 1 joule per second. So what is the first formula I am teaching you now? Power is equal to W by T. Work done by T. Okay. Okay. Now, we have learned what is power. What is energy? When we want to do your work, we need some ability. No. That ability, that capacity to do the work is called energy. For example, when we eat, we get energy. That energy, using that energy, we do some work. Right? Now when we do work, it will get converted into another energy. So now work and energy, we are interconvertible. Work will get converted into energy. Energy will get converted into work. They are all very related terms. Okay. So, work is strictly equal to energy. So, this formula I can write as power is equal to work done by time. So, I told you work and energy are interconvertible. They can be changed. So, in the case of work done, I can write energy. So, now the second formula of power I am saying to you. Power is equal to E by T. What's the first formula? Power is equal to W by T. Right? Now coming to the unit of energy. I told you here unit of work is joule. Right? So now they are interconvertible. I said no. Which two are interconvertible? Work and energy. Now as they are interconvertible, energy will also have unit as joule. So joule is the unit for work and energy. So remember, both work and energy will have unit, same unit, that unit is joule. Okay? But what is the unit of power? Unit of power is watt. What are the greater units? Kilowatt and megawatt. Okay? Now we have some other formulas for power that I have written here. Based on this, we will do sums. Okay? Right. Now, P is equal to VI. This is your third formula. First formula is this. Second formula is this. Now, third formula I am saying. P is equal to VI. Where P is power, its unit is watt. V is voltage, its unit is volts. I is current. So all these notes I'll give as notes children. Read well. The above.